伸ばす。
In 600 feet, turn left onto 7th Avenue.
What? Okay, maybe I should look at the map apps, because I don't really know where I'm going. I went on a really exciting Google Maps app tour of Squirrel Hill completely unnecessarily. It's okay, I've arrived. I'm here at Carnegie Mellon University. I'm about to interview Drew Davidson. Okay, you know why I'm here, right?
I'm not so sure.
It's because I'm in on your secret.
Okay.
I know. There's hawks outside, by the way.
Yeah, there are.
Oh, gosh, it's crazy. Okay.
We have nature.
Nature. I know that you're a hero in disguise.
Oh, ooh, that one.
All heroes show courage in the face of fear.
All right.
And you're talking to me. That's brave.
I would agree.
See? I knew you were a hero. I knew it.
All right.
Did you wear your top secret hero costume
no.
today? What's your hero theme song?
Whoa.
What's the
Here
tune?
I am to save the day. A mighty mouse is... Oh, it's Mighty Mouse. He's on his way. That's a good one.
Here I come to save the day. That means that Mighty Mouse is on the way.
Heroes save lives.
Okay. Yes, I would agree with that.
Whose life have you saved today?
Today, no one.
Yet.
Maybe a bird. I don't know.
How'd you save a bird?
Just watching.
Oh, I'm feeling... I think I'm gonna faint. Catch me.
Ugh.
Ah, see, he saved me. He totally saved me. Otherwise, I would have, you know, had a concussion. Heroes.
Okay.
Are always true to their hearts.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I would agree with that one, too.
Yeah. So what's your heart telling you right now?
Right now, there's a little trepidation.
Yeah.
Just being honest. But,
Heroes are always honest.
Always. Sometimes a white lie is an okay thing.
True. True.
Ooh. I think it's a good day to, like, be incognito, because I think that's how you can be a hero sometimes. Like, by not having your public face and getting credit for it.
That is so true. And on the way in here, I noticed there were lots of superheroes in the hallways.
Here I come to save the day. That means that Mighty Mouse is on the way.
Do you have like a PhD in heroes?
Well, you know, sort of-ish. You want it to be aspirational for people to think about ways of to do better, to do the next thing, to, you know, even create new heroes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's what I think. Like in
nothing wrong with Superman or Batman or Spider-Man or Karen. I hear she's heroic.
Sometimes, you know, I like to keep it on the down low, though.
Yeah, right.
You know.
I don't know.
Do you have a hero sidekick?
Ooh, two. My dogs, definitely.
On the sea or on the land.
I read this thing about how dogs experience the world through smells. Their sense of smell is so much attuned than ours, like 200% in some dogs. That they actually are able to see the past and the future. Because they can be walking down the street and they can sense that they're coming up to something because they can smell it from afar.
Wow.
And when they come up to like somewhere where a lot of dogs have been, for instance, you know, doing their business, they can kind of say like, oh my God, there's like 7 dogs here this past week. They have this more elastic sense of time.
Here I come to save the day.
So what kind of hero are you? Are you like a folk hero? Or a reluctant hero?
What's so sad right now in our culture, if you want to stand out, all you have to be is polite. Notice the fact that somebody else is having a day, too.
It's those little simple acts that can change the world.
Mm-hmm.
Who is your arch nemesis?
Whoa. The idea of, like, apathy. You get people to care. Like, about, like, get civically engaged or about, like, improving education or, you know, getting involved in, you know, their neighborhood, stuff like that. It's like, it's so easy to just go, not my problem. Have you ever done that where you're superheroes? So like, what's your superpower and then what's your weakness? And I was joking with my wife because her superpower is she's really good with color. So like she can like become invisible because of how she can like bend colors to her will. And her weakness would be like really garish color clashing. Because my superpower is to like help people calm down and relax. And my weakness is if I get hot, I get, you know, then I just can't do it because then I get worked up.
Heat is like kryptonite for you.
Yeah, exactly.
Some people say hero is not a noun, it's a verb.
Ooh, I'd agree with that. Because I think it's a process. It's not like, you know, I'm a hero and I'm done. It's like, yeah, it's like every day you go through it. We have this little sign on our door. It's a quote from like Benjamin Franklin. What good will you do today? That's always a good way to try to think about how you start the day. Are you adding something awesome to the world as opposed to adding something awful? Or are you maybe even worse just being average? Yes, sir, when there is a wrong to right. One of the things that we do around here is everybody takes improvisational acting. And it's not because we want, you know, it's like programmers and artists and designers and producers, and we don't want people to be funnier or better actors, but it's all idea about sharing. Like sharing credit, sharing the stage, you know, thinking about how to brainstorm together and how this thing you're doing together is more important than like, you know, I'm smart and I'm the funny one. You know, it's like, no, if we work on this together, we're going to do something we have never done. There's so much we can do together, like a Renaissance team. Like there's nothing wrong with a Renaissance person who can do everything, and they're out there. But it's like Renaissance teams are equally interesting, necessary, valid. Fun.
Yeah, I agree.
But people can suck. It's been a pleasure, Karen.
It's been my pleasure, too. On the sea or on the land, he gets the situation well in hand.